I just wanted to say good morning and welcome everybody, and thank you for coming today to pay respects to all of our local veterans. If you are a veteran, please stand or raise your hand so that others around you may acknowledge you and thank you. Thank you. We'd like to begin our ceremony today with the Pledge of Allegiance, and then we'll be placing a wreath out at the flagpole on the field. So if you are able to stand and would like to join me in the Pledge of Allegiance, please do so. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. We'd like to honor all of our veterans, past and present, by placing a wreath outside before the flagpole. So please join Army Specialist E5 and Commander of the VFW Post 1046, Robert Graham, and Navy E5 Second Class Petty Officer Zano Spada, and the Brockton Honor Color Guard as we go outside to place the wreath. If you're able to join us and would like to do so, you can follow us outside.
Present. Order.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us outside. And now at this time, I'd like to introduce Janice Fitzgerald, our director, to speak.
Wow, it's so quiet.
Good morning, everyone. What a gorgeous day it is outside, bright, sunny, a little chilly, but we'll take it. And thank you all for being here today. I'm Janice Fitzgerald, the director at the Brockton Council, of the Brockton Council on Aging. Some of you may know this is our temporary hangout for about a year while they're remodeling our facility on Father Kenny Way. So we've settled in nicely. We've welcomed some new members, and we're excited for what the future is going to bring us at our new place. I want to start first by saying thank you to Army Specialist and Commander of VFW Post 1046, Robert Graham, and Navy Second Class Petty Officer Zano Spada for leading us out to the flagpole this morning. Also, I would like to extend my thanks to John Messia, Director of Constituent Services in community engagement in the mayor's office, and all our elected officials that are here with us today. In addition, we have Kelly Young, the veterans agent, Register of Deeds John Buckley, the Brockton Police Honor Guard, Police Chief Brenda Perez, the Brockton Rotary Club, and thank you, Sergeant Daniel Clark, who's going to bring us some wonderful music a little later. Also, I want to say a big thank you to Christina, who did all the hard work to get this room set up for us today. Yeah. And most importantly, thank you to all our veterans. Those of us who live in freedom will always be grateful to all our veterans, past and present, who helped preserve it. Thank you very much. At this time, I would like to introduce Lance Corporal John Messier, who is here on behalf of Mayor Sullivan, who's a little bit under the weather today. So, John?
Thank you, Janice. Good morning, everybody. Mayor Robert Sullivan sends his best wishes and veterans praise to all of you here for Veterans Breakfast at the COA. He is feeling a little bit under the weather still, and we do need our mayor back up and running to run this wonderful city of champions in Brockton. So we send our best to him to recover as quick as possible. I do want to thank everybody here that is a veteran and a member of the families of the veterans. That's the backbone of this country. I'm proud to be a United States Marine, along with my dad, who is a Korean War veteran, Marine Corps. We share that bond. He couldn't be here today at 88 years old. He's at home resting, and I did get to speak with him prior to coming here, and he sends his best to everybody. A special bond being a veteran, that is the backbone of the country. That is what we are made of, red, white, and blue. Sharing that common bond of giving it all, not caring about the status that you have, not being a male, a female, an age, a color, it doesn't matter. It matters the fact that you gave everything for your country. You carry that through day in and day out to be either a parent, either a worker, either a United States citizen, or somebody just caring for somebody else. So that special bond is in this room. That special bond's carried throughout the country, carried overseas, and we have the most special bond that we can possibly have, and that's being a veteran. So I want to wish you a special breakfast today. I'm proud to be up here honoring the words from the mayor's office, and if there's anything we can do for any of your veterans, Kelly Young, who's Veteran Service, VSO, in the veteran's office, is a phone call away with her staff. I'm in the mayor's office, and I encourage you, anything at all you need from one veteran to another, please reach out. God bless. Thank you.
Thank you very much. If you could just, we are having some special guests arrive. Every year we invite some of our friends, our veterans from the VA hospital, and they're just getting here now. So welcome very much. Glad to have you all. And I was just informed that Rep. Rita Mendez has some winter coats they're bringing in that they would like to donate to any veterans that are in need. So we'll probably put them out in the hallway there. Great, thank you very much. At this time, I'd like to introduce our veterans agent, Kelly Young. And you know I'm gonna share the story, right? So Kelly got hired as the city's veterans agent, and we were at a department head meeting and walked into the room, and this beautiful young lady was sitting, I think probably in my chair, but I didn't say anything. And as I walked by, she said, "Hello, Mrs. Fitzgerald." And I looked over and I was like, "Wow, don't ever call me Mrs. Fitzgerald." And oh my goodness, look at you, you're all grown up. So I've known Kelly for many, many years, her family, wonderful family, brothers. So I was very proud and happy to learn that she took over this position. So Kelly.
Thanks, Janice, not Mrs. Fitzgerald. We played a lot of sports in my family, so Janice introduced Jack Buckley, and he'd be Mr. Buckley, right, at all the baseball games, and now it's weird. I feel like I'm going to get in trouble when I talk to them and call them by their first name. So similar to the military, right? Have you ever called somebody by their first name, and it feels weird, right, your last names? I'm young, and when people call me Kelly, I have to kind of like remember, is it my mom? Am I in trouble? Or is it a friend, you know? But I'm sure you're sick of hearing me speak. I've been at every event, every day, probably except Sunday. I got a day off on Sunday for the last week around the city. I don't really have any new things to say, but I want to thank everybody for their service and talk a little bit about what we do in our office. So we do local, state, and federal benefits. The local benefits are like the property tax work off, and then we partner with some agencies in the community, like Rep Cassidy and Rep Mendez have winter coats, so we help out with stuff like that. At the state level, there are Chapter 115 benefits, the annuity, some of the burial benefits, and then at the federal level, we don't administer them, but we liaise for VA and federal benefits. And that's very vague, I know that, and I say that because I don't have enough time to tell you exactly what all those things are, but you should call our office. Cece has her camera, she's videoing, she's doing our social media management right now, but she has the service dog employee of the day every day, Chewy. So if you see Cece, she and I can do the same things for you, right? Like I'm the director, but that just means I do the budget and talk and do the boring stuff. But in terms of what we do for you, Cece and I do the same stuff for the people. And then Jerry and Josue are the administrative assistants in the office. And you can kind of pick your service unless you're Air Force or Coast Guard, right? So Cece's Navy, Josue and I are Army, and Jerry's a Marine Corps vet. And if we can get some more staff, hopefully we'll be able to hire from the other branches too. We'll see how they interview. But I encourage you to call us and find out what you're eligible for or what's going on. And you know, now that I've had a little over a year, we have more partners now to connect you to stuff that we don't necessarily do, but I'll give you an example. Remember that microburst, the thunderstorm? It like took down fences and stuff. We had people calling to see if there was any aid for vets who had like damage to their yard or their fences. And at the time, we didn't. We had nothing. That's not something that we do. But now I know some people that have nonprofits that can help with things like that. So it's worth a call. And when you call, like I said, there's only four of us for a city of 100,000. If you have to leave a message, leave a message. We answer all the. We call everybody back. But when we're with folks, which is usually all day, every day, we give people 100% of our attention because these are usually complicated things and we can't be distracted. So please call us. Please get on our mailing list. Come to the parades. If you're on social media, follow us on social media. We do have a physical mailer that we send by postal mail, so please stay in touch because a lot of stuff is time sensitive in terms of applying or if there's a cutoff date. So I hope you reach out, and I hope you have a great breakfast. It's steaming. Can you smell it? All right, I'm done. I want to eat. So, Janice, let's go. Thank you.
Yep, she hasn't changed. She's the same spunky young lady I remember way back when. At this time, I'd like to invite up. Give me 1 second. I lost my train of thought. Army Specialist E5 Commander of VFW Post 1046, Robert Graham.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to thank all our special guests. Excuse me. Unfortunately, the mayor couldn't be here, but Linda Brady is here, Shirley Asak is here, and anybody else out there, Janice, anybody else out there that I can't see. But anyway, today is a day of celebration and recognition, but in some ways, it's a solemn one. Originally observed as Armistice Day, the 11th day of the 11th month, in the 11th hour, marked the anniversary to the end of World War I. As our country and much of the world mourned, there remained a desperate glimmer of hope that the Great War could indeed be the war to end all wars. Of course, we know that wasn't the case. World War II followed less than two decades later, then the Korean War, the Vietnam War, the Gulf War, and it was only 2 years ago that we ended America's longest war, the war in Afghanistan. As war and conflict continue, so did the courage and sacrifice of American men and women who defended our nation and its interests. Many paid the ultimate sacrifice. In 1954, as a result of a years-long campaign led by World War II veteran Raymond Weeks, Armistice Day became Veterans Day, a day to commemorate all veterans of all wars and all eras, past, present, future, living, and dead. While the hope of world without war faded, we continue to mourn our fallen. November 11th became a day of celebration and gratitude. And so, on this 69th Veterans Day, I am grateful to be here with you to honor all veterans who came before us, those who stood alongside us, and those who will come after us. To those veterans here today, thank you. Your service and sacrifice represents the best of us and the best of America. We salute you and appreciate the great cost that often comes with serving. Veterans and service members, are you able to please stand and be recognized? Or raise your hand. Let's also take a moment to acknowledge those families who have helped shoulder the weight of war and burdens of sacrifice. To the mothers, the fathers, spouses, children of our military men and women, thank you. Veterans Day is a time when we remind our fellow Americans to stop and say thank you to those who serve. Those simple words are important, but they are also just the beginning. I encourage you, whether civilian or veteran, to dig deeper and ask questions and listen to what they have to say. Take an interest in the experiences and sacrifice of those who allowed us to live out our own stories in a country that is safe and free. Doing so is more powerful than you know. And I'd like to end by asking a question. How many of you know the definition of a veteran? Okay. I think I said this last year, but I'm going to say it again. The question is, what is a veteran? A veteran, whether active duty, discharge, retired, or reserve, is someone who at one point in their lives wrote a blank check payable to the United States of America for an amount up to and including their lives. That is honor, and there are ways too many people in this country today who no longer understand that fact. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Robert. I just want to acknowledge Fire Chief Brian Nardelli. Thank you for being here today. So again, thank you to all of you for being here today. Thank you so much to our veterans. And at this time, we're going to have our breakfast. So, Michelle, we're going to serve our guests from the VA hospital first. Do we have volunteers to serve them?
Yes.
Okay. So if we could get them served, and then Michelle can call you up, I guess, by tables. Make sure you help yourself to coffee, juice. If there's anything you need, let us know. Again, thank you all. Thank you to all our elected officials. And enjoy your breakfast.
Hi, everyone. How was your breakfast? Good? All right. So I would like to introduce the singing trooper, Sergeant Daniel Clark, is going to perform for us. He's getting ready, getting warmed up. Let's give him a round of applause, please.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor for me to be here today, and
Many people know me as Danny Clark or the Singing Trooper, but before all that, I served in our United States Marine Corps. So I have the greatest respect for all of you ladies and gentlemen who are here today. And before we get going, I respectfully submit that I'd like to open with the number one song of all time. It's going to be a prayer not only for our military, but for our great men and women who are here, public safety, our police, our fire, our EMS, everybody who takes care of us. You all know this. Sing along with me. Bless you all. You know, you guys know me. I love singing my patriotic music. You know these songs. I know these songs. You love these songs. I love these songs. I want you to put your hands together. I want you to clap. I want you to have a great time. If you want to get up and dance, God bless you. Whatever you want to do, come on. Have some more breakfast. I don't care. Come on. Hup. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Red, white, and blue, where there's never a boast or brag. And should old acquaintance be forgot, keep your high on that grand old flag. Come on, this land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. As I was walking, put down that highway, I looked above me, down in the skyway, I looked below me, down in the valley. This land was made for you and me. There's your part ready. The stars at night are big and bright. If up in the heart of Texas. The prairie sky is wide and high. Deep in the heart of Texas, the sage in bloom is like perfume. Deep in the heart of Texas reminds me of the one I love. Deep in the heart of Texas, come on now. I'm Yankee Doodle, that's it. Yankee Doodle, do or die. A real lineup, you are my Uncle Sam, born on the 4th of July. I've got a Yankee Doodle sweetheart, she's my Yankee Doodle joy. Oh, Yankee Doodle, came to town, riding on a pony. I am a Yankee Doodle boy. Over there, over there, send the word over there. And that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drum, rum, the tom, and everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer, send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't come back till we're over there. Ready? Oh, when the Saints go marching in, oh yeah, honey. Oh, when the Saints go marching in, Lord, I wanna be in that number. Oh, when the Saints go marching in, oh, when the sun begins shine, oh, when the sun begins to shine, Lord, I wanna be in that number. Oh, when the sun begins to shine, yes, sir. Oh, when the Saints go marching in. Oh, when the Saints go marching in. Lord, I wanna be in that number. Oh, when the Saints go marching, sing it. Outstanding. You guys are great. Outstanding. Wow. You know, I always want to know where these great songs come from, and I found out this next song came from a little place called North Andover, Massachusetts. And way back in the day, there was a young man by the name of Samuel Smith, you see, and Samuel Smith was so upset about the British fleet bombing our nation's capital that out of spite, he stole the British national anthem, God Save the King. He changed the words, and for 100 years, we were singing this song as our national anthem before we adopted the Star Spangled Banner. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was a little boy, I grew up singing this. Please join me. My country, 'tis of thee. But there's another song that also comes from Massachusetts. And wherever I travel around this nation, I tell the story about the young lady who wrote it, because she was one of the first literary professors at the great Wellesley College. She traveled this great nation. She made it all the way out to the Rocky Mountains, to Pike's Peak. In 1893, she climbed Pike's Peak while she was seated on the back of a mule. She got on top of the mountain, she looks back over this nation. She is so moved by everything that she sees, she writes a poem. That poem is put to music. It is so beloved, many people think that this song should be our national anthem.
If you go right down the road to Cape Cod, Falmouth, Massachusetts, right in front of the public library, there's a beautiful statue of this young lady in her honor. Her name, Catherine Lee Bates, from Falmouth, Massachusetts, and she's the one who wrote the one and only America the Beautiful. Now I have this incredible orchestration. Everybody here knows this song. Please sing with me, America the Beautiful. You know, ladies and gentlemen, I told you the story about Catherine Lee Bates, how she wrote the poem, but what people don't realize is that in the beginning, America the Beautiful sounded different. It was attached to another piece of music, which you also know very well. The music that you know was written by a choir master out of New Jersey. He was going to his favorite place, Coney Island. He's in the middle of the water. He's on a ferry boat, right? And he's in the middle of the water. He gets this divine inspiration to write this melody. Where is he going to write it down? He has nowhere to write. His buddy, who he's traveling with, rips the cuff of his sleeve off, and Samuel Augustus Ward writes the melody that you know to be America the Beautiful. Now, if you look in vintage Methodist hymnals, you'll see Materna or Blessed Mother. You say, wait a second, I know this song. Yes, they took his song, her poem, together, voila, America the Beautiful. However, in the beginning, it wasn't that easy. We all set? Okay, what happened was is that America the Beautiful was attached to a piece of music that you all know and love very well. What I'm gonna do is a demonstration. I'm gonna sing for you how America the Beautiful used to sound with its original tune. I wanna see if anybody can guess what it is. Now, I will say, you all know this tune very well. Everybody in here sings it at least once a year. And it's a famous Scottish folk hymn. And this is how America the Beautiful used to sound.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, a purple mountain, majesties above the fruited plain. Shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. I think this young lady guessed it right away.
Oh, that's right. What is your name, young lady?
Sue
Snyder. Sue. Well, Sue did, in fact, guess the original tune to America the Beautiful is Auld Lang Syne. And now Sue has to sing it with me. Come on now. Here we go. Here we go. Ready? That's the story of America the Beautiful, and if they've decided to keep it like that, I have no idea what we would sing on midnight New Year's Eve. Now, this next song, I have performed over 4,000 times in my career. Every time I perform it, I take the greatest honor and the greatest pleasure. I'm going to tell you a little story before I sing it. It was done by the great Johnny Cash, and this story is known as the Ragged Old Flag. And then I'm going to go into our Star Spangled Banner. Now, I know many folks here have a trouble standing up, so I know there's no disrespect if you need to stay seated, but once again, this is going to be Ragged Old Flag right in to the Star Spangled Banner. You know, I walked across the county courthouse square. On a park bench, I saw an old man, and he was sitting there. I said, "Your courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "Nah, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your flagpole, it's leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat." And I sat down. He said, "Is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." He said, "Well, we don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a hole in that flag over there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And you know she got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key sat watching her writing, 'Oh, say, can you see?' She got a big rip in New Orleans with Pakenham and Jackson tugging at her seams. And she almost fell at the Alamo. Saw that Texas flag, but they waved on, no. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg. And that south wind, she blew hard on our ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II, and she hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam, Afghanistan. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved on our ships upon the briny foam, and now you know, they've almost done quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she has been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is sometimes scandalized throughout the land. She's been getting threadbare, and she's wearing thin. But she's in good shape for the shape she's in, 'cause she's been through the fire before. And I believe that she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, and we lower her down slow every night. We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her up just right. You know, on second thought, I do like to brag, 'cause I know we're all mighty proud of our ragged old flag. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United States of America, our Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars bear o'er the perilous fight, o'er the rampart we watched, so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
Thank you so much. I also want to extend a welcome to our commander of the VFW post, sir. Thank you so much for your remarks. Thank you. Thank you. You know, I get to talk to kids a lot in school about being a veteran. And I tell them, I said, to become a veteran, they send us to a special school. And that special school is called boot camp. And then I say, we get special teachers, too. They're called drill instructors. And they make sure your every day is full of fun and adventure. Now, as a United States Marine, I went down to a place called Parris Island, South Carolina. There's two places in this nation they train Marines. One is in Parris Island. If you live west of the Mississippi River, they send you a place called MCRD San Diego. We call them the Hollywood Marines. They issue them suntan lotion and sunglasses. But anyway, we have a good time. But, you know, in boot camp, there's only 1 hour every week when you had peace. And that 1 hour is when they recommended that everybody go to church or chapel on Sunday. And the funniest thing is, every single teenager went to church. When's the last time you saw that? Because for 1 hour, the drill instructors were not allowed to mess with you. It was like the hand of God was over the chapel, kind of like a force field, you know. And you could see the drill instructors outside because they weren't even allowed in church. They were outside circling back and forth like a pack of hungry wolves. And you know what they were thinking. They're like, you may be gods now, but I'll get you about an hour. We would end every service singing a very famous hymn. Many of you know this as Eternal Father. Now, all my Navy brethren know that this is the Navy hymn. And you may be saying to yourself, Dan, that's kind of crazy. Why are the Marines singing a Navy hymn in boot camp? Well, as all my Navy brethren always remind me, we, the Marines, are under the Department of the Navy. We are the Navy's little brother. Way back in the day, our Navy ships were being attacked by pirates. And they said, we need some crazy men who can fight off these pirates on our Navy ship. Where are we gonna get somebody crazier than pirates? I know, we'll go into a bar. So they go to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, a place called Tun Tavern. Someone stepped in and said, I'll buy all the shots. Now, who wants to join up and fight the pirates? And that's how the Marine Corps was born. Now, everybody here knows the opening verse of Eternal Father, and I hope you sing with me. And I'm also going to sing the verse that was written for our United States Marine Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Navy hymn.
here, their land to serve, thy law fulfill. Be thou the shield for a evermore from every peril to the poor.
So this is the point of the program. I have to make a confession. And the confession is that I never had the great honor of growing up in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. I grew up in a state south of here, which happens to be very famous now. It's the state of Delaware. And I grew up in Delaware. My father was a professor of genetics and biology at the University of Delaware. As a matter of fact, he was one of the top 100 men of science in the world. He used to shoot bugs up into space for NASA. He used to check the radioactive and mutative aspects on living organisms in outer space before the astronauts went up. Now, the reason I tell you this is that's how I got here to Massachusetts, because for some reason, all of the scientists, not only in the United States, but internationally, they all collaborate at a place called Woods Hole, Massachusetts on Cape Cod in the summer. The Marine Biological Laboratories, the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute. So every single summer, my dad, Dr. Clark, he used to drag me out of Delaware and force me to go to Cape Cod. I had my own Boston Whaler fishing for bluefish or at the beach looking at the pretty girls. It was just child abuse, I tell you.
No.
It couldn't have been a better upbringing, but the honest fact is, growing up in Delaware, I had never, ever, ever heard Irish or Celtic music. And it wasn't until I became the singing trooper that many on my command staff of the state police would say, you know, son, you need to start singing some Irish tunes. Well, my mom, when I was little, she tried to get me to learn this next song. She'd say to me, oh, Danny. Yeah, I didn't get it. I was a blockhead. It wasn't until I first learned this song for a fallen police officer on Cape Cod. I sing it at happy and sad occasions, and I've been telling the story about Danny Boy for many, many years, and I had an Irish historian come up to me and say, Dan, you're telling the story all wrong, you know? I said, please enlighten me. He says, well, in Irish tradition and in Irish lore, when the pipes would play and echo down the valley and over the glen, it was time for the eldest man of the family to go fight the battle. And in this song, if Danny Boy's the eldest man of the family, it follows that the grandfather and the father have since passed away. This famous song was written for a mother who is standing with her eldest son, Danny, sending him off to war. Now, I know this is very personal to many people in this room, and you don't have to be Irish to love it. It's also personal to our family because, you see, we have our own Danny Boy. And our Danny Boy, he grew up as an elite gymnast. He was your state champ, New England champ, national champ on the pommel horse, and then he wanted to go off to college. We drove him down to the great state of Maryland. And they had this beautiful state capital there known as Annapolis. It is the home of our United States Naval Academy, where our son Daniel became a midshipman. He competed for Navy men's gymnastics for all 4 years. In 2022, he graduated. He shook the hand of the President of the United States, and they made him a second lieutenant in my United States Marine Corps. And now I have to salute my own son. He is currently stationed at a place that's very famous. It's known as Pensacola, Florida. It is the home of our United States Blue Angels, and that is where the United States Navy trains all of her aviators, both Navy and Marines. Our son is training to be a Marine Corps pilot. So when I sing this song, obviously I'm singing it for Danny. But I always offer it to you. For all those folks that you hold so deep in your hearts and wish could be here with you right now on this glorious morning. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Irish classic, O Danny Boy. No crying. Ladies and gentlemen, as a United States Marine, obviously I take the greatest pride in my service, but I have the greatest respect for all of those who have served. Now, you know my hymn, from the halls of Montezuma to the shores of... Oh, yeah. If you serve the United States Army, you know your hymn to be Caissons Go Rolling. Yes, they changed the word just a little bit, now called Army First to Fight. If you served in our United States Navy, your iconic song has always been Anchors. Oh yeah, if you serve in the United States Air Force or Army Air Corps, your hymn, Wild Blue. Very good. Now we have a new branch of service. It's known as the Space Force. They just unveiled their hymn and their motto, Semper Supra, always above. Now, in addition, this group of men and women who not only guard our shores, but they're deployed at combat venues all over the world. Their hymn, Semper Paratus, always ready. And then finally, there's a group that was long forgotten, supporting and defending this nation since 1775 in both peace and in war. I'm referring to our merchant marines. They have a hymn also, Heave Ho, My Lads, Heave Ho. Now, as always, I would respectfully request, when I sing your hymn, if you have served, had a family member who has served, been married to a serviceman or servicewoman, if you can't stand up, put your paw in the air. I want to recognize each and every one of you, the order of military hymns that is going to be the Merchant Marines, the Coast Guard, the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Space Force, and then the United States Marine Corps. These are the men and women who defend the great United States of America. Do I have any Merchant Marines on deck? Merchant Marines. Any Merchant Marines in the room? Here we go. It's a long, long way to go. It's a long, long tug with the hatches full, braving the wind, braving the sea, finding our treacherous foe. Heave-ho, my lads, heave-ho, is the sea full high and low. Oh, we can cross any ocean, sail any river, give us those goods and we'll deliver. Damn the submarines. We're the men of the Merchant Marines. Do I have any Coast Guardsmen on deck? Coast Guard, Coast Guard. We're always ready for the call, but we place our trust in thee. Through serpent storm and howling gale, I shall a purpose be. Semper Paratus is our guide, our fame and glory too. To save and fight to die. I, Coast Guard, we are for you. Where's my army? Army, let me see it. Offers to fight for the right and to build a nation's might, and the army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fights until the battle's won, and the army goes rolling along. But it's high, high, hey, the army's on its way. Call up your cadence and strong, two, three. For wherever we go, you will always know that the army goes rolling along. Okay, where's my Navy? Navy! Anchors away, my boys, anchors away. Farewell to college joys, we sail at break of day. On shore, drink to the foe, until we meet once more. Just wish you a happy voyage home. How about my Air Force? Where's my Air Force? Up we go into the wild blue yonder, flying high into the sun. Oh, down we dive, smudge our flames from under, hats above. Give him the gun. Off we go, assuming to meet our thunder. Off in one hell of a rope. We live in faith, but down in flame. That'll stop the U.S. Air Force. How about my Space Force? We're the mighty watchful high, guardians beyond the blue. The invisible front line, wolf fighters brave and true, boldly reaching into space. There's no limit to our sky, on guard both night and day. where the Space Force from on high. All right, Marines, lock your bodies up. From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, oh, we will fight our country's battles in the air, on land, and the sea. Of us to fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean. We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines. Hurrah! From our merchant marines to our Coast Guardsmen, our Army, our Navy, our Air Force, our Space Force, our United States Marine Corps, we wish you Godspeed and stay safe. Thank you so much. You know, as part of the as part of the armed services, you know that all our different branches, we joust with each other all the time. We give each other jokes. You know, I'm used to be calling the bellhop of the sea. You know, the whole thing. Anyway, but you know, in all honesty, what this gentleman said is that we're all together. It doesn't matter where you come from, what you look like, what you believe. We all stand together. And the gentleman here representing our Coast Guard, most people don't realize that the United States Coast Guard has only one Medal of Honor winner. His name, Douglas Monroe. World War II. His mission, he was in a landing boat all by himself. He only had one 50 caliber machine gun mounted on the deck. His mission, to go to shore and rescue, offload 500 US Marines who are under enemy machine gun fire. As he approached the shore, Douglas Monroe realized there is no way these Marines are going to get out under this hail of machine gun fire. So this young man took it upon himself to turn the landing craft sideways to block the rounds that were coming downrange, and he engaged the enemy with the 50 cal machine gun all by himself. He was killed in the line of duty. He saved 500 United States Marines. For his valor, he was given the Medal of Honor. That's why me and everybody here knows at a moment's notice, it doesn't matter what branch you serve in, you're all going to be standing next to each other when it comes right down to it. There's a song here that I'm about to do that you don't hear very much. But the reason I put it in today, because of the steep history from Brockton, Massachusetts. Because you see, way back in the day, there was a governor Shaw, and he decided he was going to create the first African-American regiment, number 54. He also created regiment number 55. There were two regiments. As they marched through Boston to great fanfare and applause, they were then dispatched to South Carolina. They marched down the streets to a song that's very, very familiar to all of you. And it wasn't until this young lady wrote the verses that everybody knew about it. Julia Howe was down outside our nation's capital. She was looking over the Union troops that were going into battle, and she heard a sergeant from one of these regiments start to sing a marching song. This marching song was so powerful it spread over the entire regiment of men. She was told, Julia, you have got to write the verses to this song. In her journal, she writes how she awoke the next morning, still in the darkness. She had to find somewhere to write down what was swirling in her mind. For in one fell swoop, this young lady, Julia Howe, wrote all of the verses to the one and only Battle Hymn of the Republic. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes are rather stored. He hath loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Come on now. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They have builded him an altar in the evening dews and damps. I can read his righteous sentence by those dim and flaring lamps. His day is marching on. Sing with me now. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Ha! Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. He has sounded forth the trumpets that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of all before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet, while God is marching on. Here we go. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. In the beauty of the lilies, Christ was born across the sea with glory in his bosom that transfigures you and me. As he died to make men holy, let us die that all are free while God is marching on. Come on now. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. One more time, sing it for me. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. Thank you, sir. I don't want to hold you, folks, but there is something we need to do out of respect. Because there's another song that comes from our Civil War. A captain from the Union Army heard the cries of a dying soldier one night. He left his tent in the darkness. He went out over the berm. He found this dying soldier. And he pulls him back into the light of his tent. To his horror, this dying soldier is his son. a Confederate soldier. His son dies in his arms. The captain asks his commanding officer, "Sir, may I have a military burial for my son?" "Denied, Captain. Your son is the enemy." "Sir, may I have a military band to play for my son?" "Denied, Captain. Your son is the enemy. You may have one instrument." The captain chooses the bugle, for before going off to war, his son was a music student. And as he reached into the uniform trousers of his son, he pulls out a piece of paper with these simple musical notes written upon it. These notes have become the song we use to memorialize those great men and women that have fallen in the defense of this nation. Ladies and gentlemen, veterans, render honors to TAPS. Standing, if the spirit moves you, God bless America.
While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair, as we raise our voices in a solemn prayer. Please sing with me. Here we go. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with horn, God bless America, my home sweet home. My home, sweet home.
One more time. Come on, let me hear it. Raise your voice.
God bless America, a land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans white with horn. God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet.
Take the high note. God bless you all. Have a great day as you go out I want you to sing with me. It's Lee Greenwood, proud to be an American. Stay safe. Love y'all.
If tomorrow all the things were gone I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife, I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, while the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. To be an American where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, gave their pride to me, and I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, cause there ain't no doubt I love the land. God bless the USA. Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, gave their pride to me, and I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, cause there ain't no doubt I love the land. God bless the U.S. And I'm proud to be an American where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, gave that right to me, and I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, cause there ain't no doubt I love the land. God bless the U.S.